And it goes a little something like this.
No.
Darren, listen to me. I'm going to ask you a question. And I'm asking you this question because you've been acting like a kitten after a twirl in the microwave all afternoon.
Yeah, but...
Let me finish. You've been acting like a kitten after a twirl in the microwave all afternoon. This microwave feline behaviour is eating up time faster than a peckish piranha on a freshly aborted fetus. Do I make myself content clear?
Yeah.
Are you ready for the question?
Yeah.
Have you eaten a butterfly?
No.
I will be more annoyed if you lie to me.
I have not eaten a butterfly. Not a whole one.
Jesus!
A wing.
A wing? When did you eat it? Soon as I left the flat this morning, I bet soon as my back was turned.
No, I waited for the car to drive off first.
Don't get clever with me, Darren. You promised me.
I'm sorry.
No more butterflies behind my back. You swore.
I'm sorry. Jesus.
What one was it?
One of the new ones.
What new one? Darren!
I'm trying to remember.
What colour was it, for fuck's sake?
Green. No. Gold. With blue fleck.
Was it red?
What did it do to you?
Famous people, political leaders,
killing them.
Assassin! fascination. You had a ripe of silver stripes.
Just a wing.
How were you assassinated?
I wasn't.
Who did you assassinate then?
No one.
Well, someone was assassinated, some fucking hell.
I saw someone being assassinated, okay?
Who?
The Americans, what? Big Teeth. No, wait, don't tell me. Kennedy!
Jack or the brother?
What?
The Dallas Splathead or the other one?
Oh, the Dallas Splathead.
Fuck me, Davin, you don't get no Dallas Splathead off a single butterfly wing.
Well, you've never even wanted, how the fuck would you know?
It's my job to fucking know, fuck me! You'd be lucky to get some third world Muslim clerk machine gun in a mosque off a single fucking butterfly wing. It was a whole one, wasn't it?
No.
Where's the other wing, then? Come on. Show me! Show me!
Alright, with the whole butterfly, you fucked it!
You fucking bastard!
But it was small!
Small!
A baby!
A baby! Oh, you don't get no made butterflies, Davin. Butterfly ears and a butterfly isn't. And that's its fucking lot.
Well, they must have a cutting child.
It's called the cat a cutting pillar rod!
Alright, well, I don't want a bloody biology lesson.
Bloody? Fuck me, you can't even talk now, you worthless pile of infected Caucasian cum. Why are we here?
What do you mean?
What are we doing? Here.
We're here to find a place.
A place for what?
Oh, I'm not fucking stupid.
A place for what, Darren?
A place to have a party.
That's right, and that party's going to start in about an hour, give or take, which means...
Which means we haven't got much time to get things ready.
Bet your fucking arse we haven't got much time to get things ready. And if we don't get things ready in time, you know what that means, don't you?
It means... We.
Me and Sphinx will be pissed off!
Oh, we don't want that.
No, we don't, because Sphinx, he has a nasty habit of slicing people's eyelids off, and he's not a happy bunny. So I don't need you dawdling around like some petrol-bombed paraplegic when you should be helping me keep Sphinx in complete content bunniness.
I am helping.
I've got news for you, butterfly babe. You ain't!
Well, it's worn off now.
Worn off? Fuck me, I've seen gang rape toddlers act with more alacrity than you.
I am acting with
alacrity! Means as bright as a polished bullet up an 8-pound arsehole.
Well, you know what? I am a polished bullet up an 8-pound arsehole.
You're a useless pile of shit up an 8-pound arsehole.
I was alone for fuck's sake.
What?
You rushed out the flat this morning. You don't tell me what's up. You don't phone, you don't message me.
Oh, so it's my fault now, is it?
Oh, I'm not saying that.
Then what are you saying, Davin?
I'm just saying, when I was alone, I got to thinking.
What have you got to fucking think about?
What?
Lots of nothing more like it to you. It's got lots, 4 years more lots.
Three.
Four? I've got stuff from before you were even fucking born. Get inside my skull and you'll be screaming to get out.
Alright, alright.
Slit my skull open. Do you know what it'd be like? Slitting open the guts of a great white shark.
Well, you know what? I've got stuff. Not like great white shark stuff, but I've still got stuff.
Tadpole stuff! Nothing! Nothing!
Is your knee still playing?
Do you care?
Well, it helps if someone rubs it.
Not you! Nothing you do helps in the slightest fucking way. Do you know what you're like? You're like an anvil around my neck. The lifeboat's sinking, and I'm trying to be the good guy and bailing us all out, but I've got this fucking anvil hanging around my neck, dragging the whole thing down!
Well, I don't understand, though.
Of course you don't understand, you nigger pack of chip once biggie cunt! You'd have to have fucking brains to understand an insult like that.
Oh, don't insult me, El.
I should be a one-man band, you know. Everybody thinks so, but they don't say nothing because you're my little brother, but I know what they're thinking. Ellie could be a star. Right fucking supernova if she didn't have that butterfly little brother hanging around her ankles like a million miles of machine gun after me.
I'm not a million miles of machine gun.
Do you know what I'm going to do? One night I'm going to fill the bath up with sulfuric acid. I'm going to say, fuck me, bro. You're a bit whiffy tonight. Why don't you jump in the basket? Your balls got soak. You might jump in and you might think,
oh, this is a bit off.
But like the remedial shit for brains you are, you'll lean back and have a soapy wankle or something. 10 minutes later, I'll pop my head in and there'll be nothing left. Whoa. Maybe that bottle cap you swallowed as a kid. A few teeth, but that'll be it. I'll pull the plug and watch you glug away.
I remember the wooden guns. You know, the wooden guns that Dad made, you remember?
Yeah, I remember. Daniel, drop it. Just help me clean up.
And he carved our names into the handles and they had triggers, but, well, the triggers didn't
move. That's enough, Daniel.
Well, help you know
me.
What? You said I haven't got stuff. Well, I have got stuff, so you listen to my stuff, okay? Dad painted them black, jet black, and he varnished them and they were really shiny, and they had these silver screws, and well, they look up but they didn't do much, and
the triggers didn't move, did they?
I just remember that. Well, Daddy give us a gun, one each, and said, we're outlaw brothers now. Outlaw brothers like Jesse James and, well, who's the other one?
Frank.
Yeah, Frank and Jesse. And you said, I don't want to be an outlaw. I want to be the sheriff. And Dad said, you can be whatever you want to be. And Dad told us to play fair. Dad said, if we would have felt the bullet hit us, then we have to fall to the ground. And we have to only play this in the garden, and we mustn't make too much noise. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
Do you know what I like best? Watching telly late at night. You know, watching that musical that Mum and Dad liked, you know, with the kids going up and down mountains and singing, Do-re-mi! Remember that?
Yeah.
I remember, on the sofa, me in the middle, Mum on that side, and Dad on that side, and Dad had the remote control. And Dad, he'd order a big giant takeaway pizza, American hot with these green chilli things and sausage bits. And he'd cut them up into four equal parts, and he'd make sure that every single sausage bit had the same amount in every part, so that we wouldn't argue, isn't that right, El?
Yeah.
Our hands would get really greasy, and Mum would say, don't wipe your hands on the sofa. I just liked the whole way, like the room was just lit by the light of the telly and the smell of pizza. And kids going, Do-re-mi! And Mum on that side, and Dad on that side, and where were you at?
The armchair.
Yeah, that was your chair. I love you so much that I could grab you and grab you.
So much that I could grab you harder and harder.
I love you so much that I could make you scream and scream.
So much that I could kick you and punch you.
I love you so much that I could punch you and kick you.
So much that I could make you bleed and bleed.
I love you so much that I can kill you and kill you.
So much that I could
I loved you so much that I could... that I could burst into flames.
Let's get this show on the road then, Brooke.
Are we still using this flat for the party then?
Good a place as any, I'd say. What would you say?
Oh, I'd say the same. I need to have my own furniture, right?
That's right.
There's no electric.
I'll check the water.
Do you want a hand in there?
Nah, I'm in my room now. You just keep getting that room ready.
Housework time. The bare flat, Elle!
What?
The bare flat, that's where we parked the car.
Fuck me, remember as well, Paul.
What a fire that must have been, eh? Would have liked to have seen that. The way the petrol was all over the old curtains and... Shit! Ow! We both seen the fire!
Yeah.
And we always burn everything up after a party, don't we, Elle?
Yeah.
And we all watch it melt and spark and...
Darren! Help me tidy the flat.
Okay.
Fuck! Lovely. Come in here. Give the bedroom a Darren special room, yeah? Lola, listen, when you get your head spinning, what about mine? I had to cancel the butterfly one. Run back and get Darren, then go and get Nibbles in her. I am calm. No, I am.
You bring the air freshener?
Bye. Make it smell nice though, yeah? It's gonna be Lola's makeup room too.
Oh, anything for Lola.
Said anything for Lola. Lola says you're an angel.
Oh, thank you, Lola.
You said thank you, Lola. Listen, when are you getting here? Well, it's the same state as before, just a block of... No, Lola, I have not got time to find a completely new location. I am. Come. Look, just drive into the square, give your beep. I'll come and get you. Love you too.
It needs them off, really.
Yeah, there's no time for that. Very nice.
Sniff.
Oh, you did good.
Did good, didn't I?
Yeah.
Said, as soon as we parked the car, you said it's a Vietnam thing, bro, and we're looking for a spy in the jungle.
No.
But I heard you talking about napalm and jungle and stuff.
No, I've been talking about napalm and jungle and stuff to Sphinx. Besides, that's not as we're meant to be when we're looking for a flat. It doesn't even matter.
Why?
Because we found a fucking flat.
Yeah, but I like doing it, Elle. Like, don't you? Doesn't it make things easier if we do it, don't it?
Just spoke to her. Well, she says she can do it. Look, Sphinx. Just don't feel right. You've never rushed a party. The party piece, he's still unconscious, you know.
Hey, wasn't we gonna use it like another war in the jungle though?
Oh, fuck off, Darren, give it a rest!
No, but wasn't it gonna be like another crime thing out, like we're detectives and someone's being shot? And we're looking for clues, and there's a spy in the jungle. Where's Daddy? Elle?
broke into a flat last night.
Well, fucking break back out and fuck back out here and go on. Oh, shit.
Oh, you ain't too convincing, mate.
It's one of those slippery ones.
Oh, right. Takes a while to get used to those slippery ones.
Yeah.
What's your name, mate?
Darren.
This flat ain't bad, Darren. Ain't bad at all. What's that smell?
Air freshener.
Very posh. Oh, you've got some comfy seats too, you lucky cunt.
Oh no, we ain't making it a home.
We?
Yeah, me and my sister.
What are you and your sister using it for? Mate, come on, I'm a neighbour for fuck's sake.
A party.
Love parties, me.
Yeah, well, this one's special.
How do you mean?
You'll have to ask Elle.
Elle? You don't mean... No, it can't be.
What?
I can't be that fucking lucky.
What for fuck's sake?
Not butterfly girl in the ice cream van, Elle.
Yeah.
Elle knows me. She drives the ice cream van down to the flyover. That's where I used to live. Second burnt out car on the left.
Oh, are you a customer?
Only a fucking regular, mate. Oh, I live for the sound of Elle's ice cream van.
Oh, Edelweiss.
What?
That's the tune on the ice cream van.
Don't, mate. Don't. Just hearing that sound makes my heart go like fuck.
Can I feel? I just wanna... Oh no, it doesn't matter.
Nah. You wanna do it, mate? You fucking do it.
Whoa.
You like that, don't you?
Oh, that's some beat.
Slip my neck open right now. My blood'll spurt right across the room, I reckon. Ow!
What's going on?
You know it.
Don't fuck off.
Mate.
Well, she knows you.
Where from?
The flyover.
She's a customer.
Everyone around here is a fucking customer.
I'm a regular.
To tell her what you buy.
A pink with sky blue dots.
Do you remember?
No. Oi.
Oh, yeah.
I gave you that bowl.
What bowl?
I got it from the statue place.
Describe the statue place, you better she knows it.
Big building, up west, glass roof, they set fire to it.
The British Museum.
Told you.
Don't.
You gave me two butterflies for it.
For what?
The bowl. It had people all around it. People with knives cutting the heart out of other people.
I know that bowl. That's in your room, Elle.
The Aztec bowl. I remember the bowl now. Fuck off.
She's living in one of the flats.
What? Where?
Down the corridor.
Darren says you're having a special party.
Did he now?
I'll help you get ready for it if you like, and I'll do it for the joy of doing it. For the joy of knowing I've helped my own personal butterfly girl. Of course, if you want to offer me something in return.
She's good, we could use an extra pair of hands.
What's your name?
Naz.
Tell me, Naz, when you were taking your pickings at the British Museum, did you happen to wonder what was left of the ancient Egyptians?
Dunno. People wrapped in bandages. An hospital.
Mummies, for fuck's sake, mummies! Tutankhamun and the sun god Ra! Surely this must be ringing a bell some fucking where.
Nah.
I've got a bell. Egypt. It's a place.
That's right. And ancient Egypt is that same place but a long fucking time ago.
What's it look like?
Sands and blue skies and, you know, them people who wear them long white dresses and them animals with them humpy things.
Camels.
Camels?
Ain't you ever been to a zoo?
It's where they keep all the dead animals.
They weren't always dead!
What were they then?
Alive. They were alive.
Shit, yeah, the zoo. That's where I saw monkeys being shot at. Live monkeys.
Who was shooting them?
These know him, and two girls as well. They were just shooting and shooting into the cage of the monkeys. They were just running up these trees and they were screeching and screeching, and fuck me, the noise. I hated that noise. And the mummy monkey, she tried to protect the two little baby monkeys, and I didn't like seeing the look on the baby monkeys' faces, you know.
The ancient Egyptians spent most of their lives working some old pharaoh.
What's a pharaoh?
Person. Pharaoh is a person. You see, he spent most of their lives building a pyramid for this pharaoh.
What's a pyramid?
Where the body of the pharaoh will go once he's dead. You see, the ancient Egyptians believed that once you die, you go to another place.
What? Like Southend?
No.
Southend's another place.
So is Dover.
The next bastard who interrupts me will get a bullet up there, cunting arsehole, do you understand?
Yeah.
Sit down. As I was saying, the ancient Egyptians, they spent most of their lives working for someone called Pharaoh. And they built this big pyramid. This pyramid had a chamber of secret corridors. And only a few people knew how to get in and out of the pyramid because, well, it was top secret information. And when the pharaoh died, and this is the point I've been trying to fucking get to, everyone who knew that secret was buried with him. You see, they had the privilege of having the pharaoh build this pyramid, but the price they paid was death. Get me?
Not really.
I wasn't talking to you, Dad, didn't you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You still wanted to help?
Well, like I said, we could still use an extra pair of hands.
Right. Naz, clear the rubbish.
Yes. You got it, Bob.
Darren, you know what to do.
You got it, sis.
Look, Darren, I'm going to go and get the party piece, okay? Lola will be here soon. She'll give her three beeps. Naz! Three beeps. Lola.
Lola.
I was just thinking, you know, while you're gone, shouldn't I have something for, you know, to protect me and Naz?
Well, there's not going to be any trouble. Besides, you've got the knife.
Yeah, but a knife...
I'm not giving you the gun!
Oh, why not?
I'm not going to keep having the same argument with you, Darren!
Don't fucking trust me.
Shut up. I've got a gun.
Yes!
That's Naz's gun! Give it back!
I don't mind.
I mind! Give it back. Give it a back! Good. Now you two, let's get this show on the road with alacrity.
Alacrity?
Alacrity. It means as bright as a polished bully up a napalmed arsehole.
Fucking hell. We best get moving then. Tell you what, you and me weren't mates, right? And you know what mates do? They share their stuff. So this gun, it ain't my gun, and it ain't your gun. It's our gun, and I'm gonna put our gun right over here. Steve, any trouble? First one gets away, bang! How's that sound?
Yeah, mate. Yeah, mate.
Come on then, alacrity.
Alacrity!
That sister of yours, she's got some brains, ain't she?
Oh, fuck me, yes, she reads books.
Fuck you. What shall I do with this?
Oh, over there. Shelves! Elle, she used to have shelves beside the bed.
You just remembered that?
Yeah, just now.
What else?
Well, Dad, he was the one who made them. He put them up and Elle, she put all the books on them.
Keep going.
Elle, well, it used to glow in the light. And I used to think that these books, the more that she learned, the more that her hair glowed. Elle wanted to be something when she grew up.
She is something. She's a butterfly girl.
Nah, something else. She wanted to be, you know, one of them people who dig up old things and stuff, like bones and stuff.
Nah, never heard of it.
I don't get half of what Elle says to me.
Old people get like that sometimes. Take my mum. I remember she told me she made a snowman once. Shoved all this snow together into the shape of a big round bloke. She put two buttons on it for eyes and a carrot for their nose. Mum told me she used to talk to this snowman, talk to it like it was really alive. And then one day, the sun came out and melted this snowman away. Mum said she was crying and crying. Even when she told me about it, she was crying her eyes out. When our neighbours got chopped up into tiny pieces, Mum didn't even cry. She just said, "We better get out of this fucking tower block, pronto." But a melted snowman, the full fucking waterworks.
Well, did you?
What?
Get out the fucking tower block, pronto!
Oh, yeah. Stayed with an uncle down by Mile End. Didn't know much about him. Though, he wore this t-shirt with a chinky top on it, flashing a tit. He used to always touch it and say, "In my dreams, in my dreams."
Must have been if he right when he took a yellow and scarlet.
Nah, he never went near butterflies.
Not even a two-tone blue?
Nah, he was odd like that.
It must be another old people thing, that.
How do you mean?
Because, well, when they were younger, there weren't any butterflies.
You're kidding.
Nah, it's true.
So, when did the butterflies start?
I don't know. And you know what? I'm going to cough all this up now, but I think the first butterfly was white.
I never seen one of them.
Oh no, they ain't around anymore.
When did they start then?
I don't know. Elle remembers. Elle, she remembers lots and lots. You know what? Her brain's like the gut of a great white shark. And so, I might just be remembering what she told me about the first butterfly and the sandstorm stuff.
What sandstorm stuff?
Fuck me, yeah, what sandstorm stuff? Listen, it gets all lost in me. I don't lose the thread, you know.
Yeah.
There was a first butterfly and there was a sandstorm. One has something to do with the other, but fuck it, you'll have to ask Elle. His name?
Her name.
Your brother's a girl?
Yeah.
But that's a sister.
Fucking hell, yeah. Your sister ain't the only one with brains, is she?
Well, where is she?
She's That's it, they killed her.
Who did? Come on, mate, you can do it.
And I look and there's a gang, they're running down the aisles and they're laughing and waving these big knife things, you know.
Oh, machetes.
Yeah. Mum grabs me by the ear. Mum pulls Stace by the hand. We try to get out through the back of the supermarket, but the gang are already there. I run down the aisles, but I slip on something. It's red. Blood. There's blood seeping out from under the shelves. I see a hand going up and down, and a machete going up and down, and then no machete and no hand, but...
Ice cream van and stuff yours.
What? Oh, Ma.
Who says it then?
Papa Spinks.
The Papa Spinks?
You've heard of Papa Spinks?
Fucking hell, everyone's heard of Papa Spinks, mate. Papa Spinks, he's big. Got him on your side, you're safe.
And you're gonna meet him. All right, come on, give me your hand.
Papa Spinks is coming to the party.
Yeah, he's bringing the party guest.
Do you think he'll like me, Papa Spinks?
Don't see why not.
I've worked hard cleaning up, ain't I?
Yeah.
You and me make a good team, I reckon.
Oh, well, you know what? That'll be up to Ellie.
You think so, don't you, mate?
I do, yeah. That's tidy enough, I reckon.
Our palace, mate.
But there's something missing. What? What? Put that over the armchair.
You've got it, mate.
No. Like this. Perfect. Shit, nearly forgot. There should be a bowl in that bag.
Yeah.
And there also should be a packet of crisps. Yeah, now put the packet of crisps in the bowl.
You got it, mate.
Yeah, but now take the crisps out the packet and pour them in the bowl.
Genius!
Because, you know, Papa Spinks likes a nice spread.
Just talking about Papa Spinks gets my heart all going again.
Oh.
Can I feel you?
Don't matter.
No, mate, if you want to do it, you fucking do it.
Fuck, yours is really going.
So is yours.
The boom!
The boom! The boom! The boom! The boom! The boom.
What are you laughing at?
I don't know. Nah, mate.
Be honest with me, mate.
Oh,
please.
No, I am, mate, I am.
Do you know what I go down like a treat right now?
A two-tone blue.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
You ever mixed him?
I did. A pure green with a purple and green fleck once.
And?
Sweet fuck all.
You should try a two-tone blue and a pure crimson, mate.
Why, what happens?
You get all the happy, floaty stuff with the blue, but you can still cave someone's head in. It's like you're doing it in slow motion. It sparkles and shines, and it's like...
What's one of those things old people used to keep the rings and the earrings and stuff in?
You mean the jewelry?
Yeah, but they get the jewelry in this box thing.
A jewelry box?
Yeah! That's what smashing her face up looks like. Like smashing up a jewelry box in slow motion.
What's your favourite butterfly?
A red with silver stripes.
I never heard of that one.
Assassinations.
How do you mean?
You see political leaders snuff it.
Snuff it?
You only can have it if you've like an experience like assassination in you somewhere though.
Don't think I've got anything like that.
Well, it can be from like old photos or from the telly, or just think about it as much as you can before you take one, and then bingo!
So, you kill this, whoever it is.
Political leaders usually, yeah. But sometimes, you're the political leader getting assassinated.
You snuff it?
Yeah.
What's it like?
The best, mate.
I want a red with silver stripes now.
Now listen, you don't always snuff someone or get snuffed. And though sometimes this is rare, you're sort of just, you know, in it.
How do you mean, in it?
You watch it.
Where's the fucking buzz in that?
Listen, don't knock it. I saw Dallas Splatter Kennedy get wasted this morning.
Dallas Splatter Kennedy?
He used to be president. He was married to some blonde hair called Marilyn Monroe. And basically, they decide to take a visit to a place called Germany, and they bump into this guy called Hitler. Now Hitler, he loved blonde people. So he tried to give this Marilyn an ass fuck, didn't he? And Kennedy, well, he got the right thump. He said, the only one I was going to give a Marilyn an ass fuck is me. So he declared war on Germany, and he started dropping all this napalm and everything all over the gap. And well, Hitler, he never had any napalm, so he,
What did he do?
Fuck knows, who cares? All I know is that Kennedy won the war, he dropped all atom bombs all over the gaff and started turning all the Germans into chinkies. And then, he dumped this blonde type of causing so much grief and started going out with this dark-haired girl from like Camelot or somewhere. And then, they decide to take a visit to a place called Dallas. Now this is where it gets good, are you listening to me?
Yeah, mate.
I'm the Camelot girl. I'm in the car with Kennedy. I'm wearing this pink dress. And the car, it's shiny black. I can feel the sun on my face. And I can hear the crowds cheering on both sides of the street. And they're looking out the windows and waving these flags. And then I hear this choking sound. And I turn to Kennedy, and he's clutching his throat. I think he swallowed his own spit or something. I lean in to help, and then his head goes to pound!
Yeah!
Brains and bones splatter everywhere, all down the front of my dress. I look at Kennedy, half his head is hanging off, and then kapow! My cunt is getting juicy and creaming up. I fiddle with the bone on the front of my dress. I feel it. I'm gonna come. The sun, the brains, the bone, the blood, and then gosh! My cunt sprays cunt juice all over the car. I try my best to cover it up, but everyone can see it. Everyone in the streets. Everyone in the world, probably, because we're on telly, ain't we? Whew!
That's horny.
Oh, tell me about it.
Let's swank each other off, yeah?
I don't know if I'm in the mood.
Oh, come on, mate.
It's not the same without the butterfly.
What can I do to turn you on?
I don't know.
Oh, come on, we're mates, ain't we?
You could get down on the floor.
You got it, mate.
And your hands, they're tied behind your back.
You got it, mate.
And you're moaning a little bit.
Mm.
No!
Wrong moaning.
It's got to be like you're being hurt and like move around a little bit.
Ow! Ow!
No, actually, I don't want to do it!
I'm just getting in the mood.
Well, I fucking ain't.
Honest.
Yeah, whatever.
Is that a score?
What?
There. Oh. Love scores, mate.
Yeah, I've got loads up. There's one in my head for you.
That's some hole, mate.
It's not a hole, it's a dent.
How'd you get it?
Someone hit me.
With what?
A hammer.
Fuck, they must have hated your guts.
It wasn't hit. It was the opposite of hate. They hit me cause they loved me, okay? They hit me cause they want to protect me from bad things. You know, that love doesn't exist anymore. It's prehistoric. I'm lucky, me. I've experienced it. I've got that all inside my head and no one can take that away from me. Where's Elbon? Shit! Fuck!
It's okay, mate.
No, she's always leaving me alone lately.
She didn't leave you alone, did she? Come on. Baboon, remember?
I remember. Mum was hurt, and she's being hit with a hammer too. And she's lying on the floor, and she ain't moving. And I drag myself over to her, and I put my hand on her chest. I can feel her heart beating, so I think she's alive. So, as long as I can feel that heart beating, everything is okay. And I'm safe.
Hello! Need some fucking help in here, hello!
You got it, boss.
It's bad. Bad, take a pic. Hello, Lola?
Nah.
Phone.
What's that?
What did I say I was gonna go and fucking get?
The party thing?
Yeah.
Message thing.
Leave a message on the message thing.
This is the party piece.
Yes, for fuck's sake.
Hello there. It's Darren. Elle wants to know.
Listen, Lola, when are you getting here? Just give us a call, yeah? There's a first aid box in that bag.
I could have left a message, Elle.
Yeah, I know, Darren.
I just needed time to think.
Darren, and drop it. Oi, nosy cunt!
Fox. What's his name?
I told you, Porterpiece!
What's his real name?
I give up.
Where did you get him?
Fuck me, you're full of fucking questions, aren't you?
I'm interested.
Don't be!
Don't look very well to me.
Shut up, alright?
He does look a bit peaky, Elle.
Fuck me, everyone's a doctor all of a sudden.
Well, he usually looks a bit more perky.
You don't look perky now.
Shut up! Just take the bag into the bedroom. Careful!
That was my fault the handle gave way. I tried to sew it, remember?
Well, it didn't give way when I was fucking holding it, did it?
Well, you're a fucking superhuman, ain't ya?
Sarcasm will get you shot.
Well?
Been worse.
Well, if the party piece is sick, then Party Guest won't be a happy bunny.
Calm down, Kevin.
And if Party Guest isn't a happy bunny, then Spinks won't be a happy bunny.
Kevin, calm down.
He's supposed to struggle, for fuck's sake.
At last, Lola, Nez! Yeah, you know what to do.
Yeah, you've got it, boss.
Wait. Take the torch.
Do you like the way I've cleaned up in that, Elle?
Yeah.
Because you come in and you don't say anything.
Where's the booze?
The booze? Oh, shit! Fuck! No, I knew I'd forget something.
Damn
it,
it's fine.
No, but why did I let Naz take the crisp and all the balls? All I knew I was gonna do it. Damn it!
What?
Foxy,
come here. It's just a little treat.
A two-tone thing?
Not a word.
No.
And you're still getting the party mood.
Yeah.
Promise me.
Yeah.
What's got into you?
Safe.
Lola? Lola? Lola?
I'm never gonna find my way out of here.
Naz will show you out. She's my mate. I'm mate. We're all mates.
What's here?
Nothing.
Elle gave me a two-tone blue. Ah!
What about me, boss?
Gob. Shut. Darren, go onto the balcony and get some fresh air, yeah?
Oh, there's gonna be a sunset.
Jesus.
Lola!
I've seen, yes.
Why can't I have a two-tone blue?
Because I need one of you in control.
I am in control!
Balcony!
Can I try a red with silver stripes?
Fuck me, you haven't all been a chatty cunt today!
Well, can I?
If you help.
Come on, mate.
You're my mate, nice.
You're my mate, too.
Bam!
Those two have seemed a bit off.
Yeah, so it seems.
And Narcisse is your new helper?
It's only temporary, Lola.
You don't think so?
Sphinx don't like strangers, you know that.
Well, if he's around long enough, he won't be a stranger, will he?
Jesus, Lola!
I don't want to hurt her. I'll handle Sphinx, okay? Promise me, Elle? Promise me.
Fine.
Look what I've got for you. Well?
Wonderful.
I've had to do 5 days of stitching in 5 hours. And you see?
Ah, oh, beautiful.
Lining?
It's a masterpiece.
And here?
Lola, honestly, it's...
He looks out to the world.
I was in a star waking him up for another 5 days, was I?
He looks sick too.
Yeah, everyone keeps telling me.
He looks starved.
Supposed to be lean.
You're on your scraps, probably.
What do you fucking take me for?
Hold him up, I want to measure his waist.
What?
Hold him up, quick. Oh, Lord, he's...
So he's lost a few pounds.
The trousers won't fit.
He can wear a belt.
I ain't got a belt.
Safety pins for anything.
Safety pins?
The jacket will cover him.
The jacket? That won't fit.
Well, his arms haven't shrunk, Lola.
His shoulders up. Look, nothing there.
Well, then we'll just pad the shoulders out with something.
Pad the shoulders out with something?
No one will know.
I know.
Darren wants another drink.
Take your belt off.
What?
Belt, we need it. Take it off. Take him a lager.
Me too.
Yeah, all right. Lola?
No.
Don't sulk.
His hair needs to wash.
Yeah, there's no time for that.
I've got my hair dry.
There's no time for that.
It won't take a second.
There's no time, okay? There's no electric, there's no hot water, there's no time.
Can you make the fucking time? Hear me? Let's get this fucking right, I need fucking time. I break hard, I break very fucking hard. Touch me. You just think you can slip a couple of fingers in me and everything will be okay.
Do you know I don't
think like that, Lola. Remember that night in the hospital? My leg? It got all infected. They put me on this antibiotic drip thing. Do you want me to stop? No. I saw one of the nurses rush over to the window and look out. Then another one. They were whispering, they were worried about something. One of them rushes and makes a phone call. Security guard comes in. He's got blood on his face. And then I hear him. Like a train getting louder and louder.
And then, bright orange. The windows light up. A car's on fire. The streets were full of people. They're all holding weapons, sticks, metal bars, guns, knives. My knee is throbbing like fuck. But I know I've got to. The noise gets louder. The crowd's in the hospital. I'm struggling into my jeans and trainers. Hurts like fuck pulling my jeans into my knee. Doors smash open. Glass breaking on the floor below. People screaming. Rush to the fire escape. I remember looking at this old woman. She's had a stroke, paralyzed. Nothing on her can move but yet, fuck me, her eyes. I can't move.
Get out!
I'm down the metal stairs. They clang all around. I'm on the main road. There's a tube station opposite, Whitechapel. It's on fire. And there, people have raided an electrical shop. They're carrying tellies. All of them clutching tellies as they run past me. I run as fast as I can. I want to get home, but everything's stopping me. Don't know where I'm supposed to go. Feet crunching on breaking glass. Smell of petrol and blood. Lots of blood. My mind's all fuzzy with the drugs. I can't think properly. What's happening? Must be a dream. There's a line of police making their way towards me. Right across the road. They're holding shields. Fire is reflecting in their shields. It's like a tide of sunset coming straight at me. Bullets whiz past me. They glow like gold.
Run!
I'm in a garden.
Someone's in the garden.
I can see someone looking out the window at me.
She looks injured.
Help me.
My brother told me to keep all the doors and windows locked and not open them to anyone.
But you do.
Yes.
You take me inside.
They bath your leg.
You put me to bed.
I sleep beside you.
In the morning. Sunshine.
I'm looking at you.
I'm looking at you.
I'm Lola.
I'm Ellie.
Oi! Give them some fucking privacy, will you? Take 10 and get your arses back here in time. Didn't you hear me? Fuck off!
matter.
It will. So, it says, hello, good day, then I go, all right, sis. And then that's it, then, yeah. But,
ready?
See you!
in there.
Is there anywhere to sit?
Of course.
Or can the party be stand?
I'll give him something.
I don't want him talking to me, Emma. I don't want him to, like, wake up.
I know, I know. Naz! Take Lola's bag into the bedroom, please. How's Darren?
Enjoying the sunset.
Jesus. Careful, Naz. There's a mirror in there. I'll have that drink now.
Naz! Lager, Lola.
Me too.
No! Told you, leave one of you in control.
Oh, let him.
All right. Me too while you're at it, yeah?
Can I ask you something, boss?
No.
What?
It's just that Darren said you'd know about the first butterfly and the sandstorm stuff.
Fuck me, Darren's on a bloody roll today!
What did he tell you?
Not much, just said the first butterfly was white.
Lightly with silver specks, actually.
Nothing's happening.
It takes a few minutes.
Are you sure he's okay?
Yes!
Go on.
What?
The first butterfly.
Oh, no, no.
I can't do anything until the party piece picks up, Elle.
Oh, then you bloody tell her then.
There was a storm one night. A very violent storm. I looked out of my window and I saw sand. A layer of sand. Over everything.
Fucking me. How come?
Now there's a question.
A freak of nature, the telly said. You see, this storm has somehow sucked up all the sand from some desert. A million miles away. And well, this cloud formed and went sand.
So they say.
You want to tell this?
No, no, you do go on.
Something sparkling on my windowsill. I pick it up. It moves.
Oh, fuck me.
It's a big butterfly. And it's white.
Well, really, it's light blue with silver specks.
But everyone refers it to white.
Now they do, and now that it's lost in this big hunting myth of what actually bastard happened, Jesus.
What's she on about?
Tell her.
Why? She's not bothered. She'll just dream her life away to fuck knows what with everybody else.
Fuck you! I am bothered. Look.
What's this?
It's me and my mum. It's the only thing I've got left.
It's
me.
Yeah, I can tell you too.
Yeah, well, I'm just saying because I've changed, haven't I? Fucking hell, you think everyone's a stupid cunt except for you.
Naz, where's me drink, mate?
Coming, mate.
What? Naz, wait. You're on a beach, yeah?
Yeah. South End.
Yeah, I know it.
You've been?
Yeah.
You remember it?
Yeah.
Look how blue the sky is. Me and Mum are both eating ice creams. See that shed over there? I think it's my dad, but I don't remember much about him, you know. It's the butterflies, ain't it?
Yeah.
If you stop taking them, do you get your memories back?
I don't know.
How come you remember them so much then?
She don't take them.
What? Not ever?
No, never.
Once she did.
Thanks, Lola.
When?
Tell her.
Green with gold black.
Another one I only heard of.
It was the second to appear.
It's gone now.
Where'd it go? What did it do?
It made you feel great.
All the butterflies made you feel great at first.
Like two-tone blues?
Oh, better than that.
They made you feel immortal.
What's that?
Like there's no tomorrow.
Why'd you stop taking him then?
Because Look, it's pointless talking about it now.
Why?
Look, when I took the butterfly, it was a different fucking time. The riots, they hadn't even started yet. The butterflies, they were just sort of a street thing, you know? Everyone took them, and why wouldn't you? You open your window, and a butterfly flew in.
Well, I don't get...
My dad stopped me.
How come?
It upset him.
I don't get it.
Of course you don't get it. No one's going to get it now.
But I want to get it. You say I'm not bothered, and when I am bothered and ask questions, you just blank me out. I'm sorry I fucking showed it to you now.
Naz, wait.
Sit down. This is like the sandstorm. The way I saw it. It's late at night. I'm sat up in bed. Our whole family's asleep. You see, Mum and Dad, they own a pub called the Dover Castle. Go downstairs and get myself a Coke and stand on the stage where Mum used to sing and did a little number. I used to love listening to Mum sing, you know. She wore this gorgeous dress that sparkled in the light. And fuck me, what is that?
What?
I can hear a sort of buzzing, you know, like a droning, like
insects, me.
Like flies.
Exactly, yeah, but like millions of flies, trillions of flies. I open my door and I look up and fuck me.
What is it?
It's not flies. It's planes, and they're way, way up, and the lights, they're all twinkling and sparkling, and I feel it on my face.
What is
like,
it?
Like dust.
What the fuck is it?
It's sand, and something else. A cocoon. A butterfly cocoon. I close the doors and go back inside. I can still hear the planes and I can still see them dropping sand and cocoons, but I don't remember seeing or hearing any fucking storm!
Flash! Boom!
Fucking hell.
I'm in garden! I play with crocodile! Crocodile goes woof, 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 woof!
Oh,
flash!
Shut
boom!
Up.
Garden shaking flowers fire!
Daddy!
Crocodile fly through the air!
Shut
crocodile,
up!
Crocodile,
do
crocodile!
Do
stop! Do stop!
Hanging on to him!
Blood on my face like rain! The whole bag of shopping back from working. Flash,
boom!
Flash,
showering
boom!
Ain't gonna help.
I'm in garden. I pay
take
the crocodile.
Take him to the bedroom, quick!
Go.
Quick!
Oh, you've got no patience.
I'm the biggest cunt I know!
You're gonna kill him, ain't ya? The party piece.
Flash. Don't you go into the next room and then help Devon in there? Sit down.
What? Come on.
So what's Paul's solution?
Told you. Party. Bringing it forward like this.
It's more than that.
Someone in Catford showed me one once, but of course it's not black, it's midnight from the wall, but people are calling it black. It's like they called the first one white. Like, a little symmetry, don't you think? Almost like someone's planned it.
What does it do?
Suicide. Thank you. latches onto it, and then it happens. Of course, you don't have to do anything because the butterfly does it all for you. You just lean back and veins burst open without blades. Necks break without rope. Your brains splat without a single one. She's taking pills or something. The next girl to be found, she was found. She was found, but this time she had a neck. And a boy. Fuck. He was only 10. He was found with his foot pierced open.
No,
I can't, because if things ever got so bad...
Things will never get
so bad. No, but if things did get so bad, if things got so bad, I was afraid that someone might hurt you, might hurt Darren, then... I made a promise to myself. Kill you both before I let anything happen to you.
Oh,
I don't know, like, I'd shoot you between the eyes while you slept or something. It's a comfort thing.
A comfort?
Don't you see? That way the power's still in our hands. We're still in control and we can choose to just... disappear. Sphinx.
He's early.
We're late.
Help!
I know, it's fine.
Is Sphinx been in the party, guess, yeah?
Yeah.
We haven't got much time to do anything now.
Just do what you can.
He's pulling up. I can see him.
Oh, we fucked up, El.
No, not yet, we haven't.
He's getting out of the car.
I need a hand in here.
Naz, help Lola.
I can see Sphinx.
Naz!
Looks brilliant.
Help, Lola, for fuck's sake!
Is that the party guest?
Yes.
She looks posh.
She?
Oh, shit. Oh.
What?
He's not brought the party guest. It's the Duchess.
The Duchess, yeah!
It's alright!
Oh, no!
It's alright!
No, but I can't do it at the party, not with the Duchess, yeah! No, can you?
He
brought the Duchess, Lola. We're gonna have to call her up, ain't we?
Who's the Duchess?
Why is he blood at you?
How the fuck do I know?
The Duchess ain't the party guest, I take it.
No, for fuck's sake, no!
Who is she then?
Oh, we're gonna have to call her up, aren't we? Surely can't go ahead with this.
No! Someone's gotta shut him up.
I can't, I'll get lost anyway.
All right, Sphinx! Oh, hold on!
Will someone tell me who the fucking Duchess is?
A friend, Naz. She's just a friend.
Then what's her fucking problem?
Naz! You show them up.
Me?
Yeah.
Or shouldn't Sphinx tell me who I am?
Well then, just tell him that I've hired you as the new full-time help or something.
Have you?
Uh-huh.
She has?
Yes.
But, shouldn't, like, Sphinx don't know me and I just think that you should just introduce
me. Shut up! Just do it, okay? Fuck me! Why are you all making everything so content difficult? Do it.
Well?
It's okay.
This way, Duchess. Well, speak to you. This way, follow me. There we go, Duchess.
Oh, Duchess!
What, Papa? What?
A chandelier. A million teardrops of glass, all twinkling and sparkling, a rainbow burst of light. Oh, Duchess.
What, Papa, what?
The furniture. It's all wood, varnished wood. It looks like antique stuff to me. Some of it's made out of carvings, mermaids, unicorns. There's gold leaf on them.
Oh, Duchess!
Papa?
You're gazing at your wonder.
Who?
The owners of this magnificent palace. They can't believe you're paying them a visit.
Oh, tell them not to be silly. I am flesh and blood like them.
Tell them yourself, Duchess.
Are they close?
You may approach the Duchess. Don't be shy, for fuck's sake.
Oh, the lambs.
Meaning for you, Duchess.
Oh, get up. I am flesh and blood like you.
Come on! She's wearing a military outfit, Duchess.
Are you in the army, miss?
Answer. Are you in the army? I think you are.
Yeah. What rank? General. Oh, Papa!
There's someone else to meet you, Duchess. Move it!
Are you in the army too, mister?
Yeah.
And what rank are you?
A general too.
Another general? Tell me, have you any nuclear weapons on the palace grounds?
They've got lots, Duchess.
Lots?
You safe, Duchess?
Very. If we get attacked, generals, I do hope you won't hesitate to bomb the shit out of the enemy.
Can I get you a drink, Duchess?
Thank you. What's your name?
Naz.
And have you worked for the generals long, Naz?
Just started today.
Why don't you go and get me in the Duchess some champagne?
Oh, champagne! You spoil me, Papa! Why is she a sphinx?
Not now, my love.
Oh, don't let me get in the way of your mentor. I'm perfectly fine sitting here. Go ahead. I can smell flowers.
There's a gorge, you know, in the back, Duchess. Roses.
Oh, roses. I adore roses. Who looks after them?
Me.
You've only been here a fucking day.
A toast. To roses and nuclear weapons.
Roses and nuclear weapons.
Now go ahead, men talk.
What's with this fucking ass?
Why is the Duchess here?
Because I want you to be, you know, drop it. What's with the stranger?
We needed the extra pair of hands. It's been a bit of a rush, you know.
You're with the party guest. It's going to be a bit late.
Late? Hey, he makes a spring party 5 days fucking forward. Now he's going to be late.
I told him to drive down the old shop on the motorway. He'll ring me when he gets there.
Doesn't feel right, Spinks.
Come on, pick him up.
He said, doesn't
feel right. And I said, you can go and pick him up.
It's getting dark.
So?
There's no lights.
We don't have any electric.
Then what the fuck are we doing here then?
Oh, we're here because the door pointed at me now when it was light.
The fucking warming.
Yeah, things cock up. Everyone shit on Ellie.
Yo, it Spinks. Listen, my people were planning a day party. Well, that's what I'm talking, because that's what you told me. A day party means daylight. Listen, if you want this fucking thing filmed, you better get here while it's late enough to do it. Listen, if anything fucks up, anything, look, then it's my fault. Call me back as soon as you get this. Could you put a charger thing or something?
I don't have a charger thing.
Candles then, anything!
I would have done if I knew the party was happening tonight.
Yeah. These things could be letting fucking infamy.
Not my fault, Sphinx.
Nah. You cruising for a bruising or something?
You leave him alone.
I've got some.
What?
Candles. Lots of them. And those things you put them in.
My girl!
Go and get them, Naz.
Excuse me, Duchess. Candles are needed for this evening.
Candlelight, how romantic. Papa?
Joy, Duchess, I'm just here. So, where are we doing the business?
Nah.
Sounds good.
Sphinx, the Duchess.
All right, I brought you here. And you're pissed off, I know.
So why bring her then?
Listen, she's getting more and more fitful the more times I leave her.
But Spinks, it's a party.
She shit herself last time I left her alone too long. You won't be able to deal with that, will you? There was shit running down her leg. I had to dig shit from the crack. Do you want to do that, do you? Or do you?
No.
What about you?
Spinks!
Candles.
The girl's a star.
I got him from that statue place.
They're fine. Elliot, I love, do you make these?
Yeah, delightful.
Could you be some help in here? Hello, brother dear.
Oh, hi, sis.
A new voice.
Sis. Could it be better? Have you been so relaxed? So
Papa, understand? Is this a new voice?
Lola's his sister.
Do you know this voice?
Introductions later, Duchess.
I love company.
Do I feel safe or what?
Naz, help Lola.
The party piece looks sick.
That's not my fault.
You've been looking after him.
I've been looking after him. I've been feeding him. I put food through the cupboard door. He loves chocolate.
He's on a two-tongue.
No, I'm not.
We ain't talking to you. Hell?
He's not on anything.
Don't lie to me. I'd be more annoyed if you lied to me, you Christian, you banished bitbox chicken. Jesus!
Just enough to soften the edges!
Don't want him his soft edges, I want him his sharp edges! Me talk sharp, you stupid fuck!
It's not his fault! I gave it him.
You gave? Jesus, listen, if anything fucks up, anything at all, they'll be serious shit! Hear me?
Yes.
Hear me, brain dead?
Stop hitting him!
Oh, really?
I feel a song coming on!
What's that, Duchess?
I can't contain it, bubbling up inside me, the thought of roses and nuclear weapons. Oh, a song throws it bubbles.
No, I can't help.
No.
Papa!
Thanks.
Then go outside and stick your fingers in your fucking ears.
Papa!
Sing, Duchess. Sing.
Thank you. Thank you. I love
this lovely little statue the other day. Statue, what I think you say, hell? About so big. Made out of ivory or marble or something like that. Something pale. You know, it's made of this bloke. Well, most of it's a bloke. It's got a body of a bloke with a head of a bar. Ring a bell to you, hell?
The Minotaur.
The Minotaur. A genius, your sister? The Minotaur. Tell me more about it, hell. Please, hell. I really want to hear it.
The Minotaur is an ancient Greek myth. The Minotaur, he lived in this maze of corridors called the Labyrinth, and... Well, I forget the details, but this guy called Theseus has to go in and kill it.
And? Did he?
It was tricky. I mean, even if this Theseus did get into the Labyrinth and kill the Minotaur, how was he going to find his way back out again?
Nasty. So what did he do?
He went into the labyrinth with a ball of string.
How is he going to kill the Minotaur with a ball of string?
It's not to cure the Minotaur, you prat. It's to find his way back out the fucking labyrinth. Ain't that right, El?
Yeah.
Well, how's it going to do that?
Jesus, cat and Jehovah! Ain't it fucking obvious? String. String! Tell him, El.
Theseus tied one end of the ball of string to the door of the labyrinth, and as he went into the labyrinth, he unwound
the string.
Yeah, so he could find his way back out the labyrinth.
Exactly.
So, did he kill the man at all?
Yeah.
Yo. Right.
Got him.
Wedding waiting.
Come on. You won't need that. He's armless.
Yeah, no one's armless.
Coming down for you now. Okay.
Where's the general's gone?
Going to get the party guest. How's it going in there?
Great. Lola's just doing his makeup. She don't need me for that. Party piece looks fucking amazing. Good. You're good at that.
Lola taught me. Look at those lips, Nas. The way they pout. The way she licks them. Don't get lips like that anymore. I tell you, the Duchess is from another time. A prehistoric time with the new altar kids.
Where am I?
Where do you want to be?
Papa?
Me?
I'm hungry.
No, it's best to continue in the back. For you, my love?
Give me Papa.
Champagne
instead.
You fucking freak. Open your mouth. Wider.
Can I have some?
It's for the Duchy. First dinner?
Yes, please.
Nice? It's for the Duchess!
I feel another song coming on.
No, Duchess, no.
But Papa, I have a song bubbling, I can't contain it.
Why don't you tell Nas about how you started singing?
Oh, I'm sure she's not interested in that.
She is.
I am. When I was a child, is that right, Papa?
That's right, Duchess.
When I was a child, I used to speak to God. I didn't know it was God at the time. It was just this voice in my head. I told other people about the voice. They gave me such funny looks. I knew what they were thinking. She's going mad. I even started to think I was going mad myself. Oh, Papa! A song through the bubbles!
Why don't you tell Nas about becoming a nun?
A nun, yes. I was a nun, wasn't I? The voice in my head told me to join this convent in the mountains. Oh, how I loved it there. Used to go for walks in the hills and the mountains. Yes, that's what I was getting at, wasn't it, Papa? The mountains, they made me sing. Oh, throat it bubbles.
You're in a very good one, was you, Duchess?
No.
Always late for prayers. The Mother Superior sent for you,
The Mother Superior sends for me and says, are you sure you want to spend the rest of your life married to Christ? I have to admit, I am not sure. She says I should. Papa, I'm in a castle. I'm in a castle by white cliffs. How did I get here?
You've been sent to the castle by the Mother Superior.
Yes. I'm in a castle. There's a man. I marry him. We have children. I sing to them. Do-re-mi. We're all so happy. Do-re-mi.
Well done, Duchess, well done! Nice champagne!
Nazis!
No, Duchess, no!
Where did they come from? Lampshades, fucking Nazis, distant bombs, people's being cooked in ovens, lampshades made of human skins!
Shush.
My husband is getting more and more depressed, the world is turning into a terrible place, the white cliffs of Dover are swarming with butterflies, people are eating the butterflies! Their tongues are shooting out like frogs. I sing and sing, but no one listens.
Is she okay?
She'll be fine. You hear me, Duchess?
I... Papa?
Some champagne?
Maybe later.
Get in here. Foxy, careful!
Is this it? Are we in the place?
Yes.
A new voice?
Shush.
Spinks! I speak to me!
Is this another general? Are you another general?
Is she speaking to me?
Yes!
No, it's a friend of the general's, Duchess.
I work in the city. Duchess? Wow. Hi, Duchess.
Oh, a kiss.
Oh, Nanas.
Hi, Nanas. I'm a party guest. Oh, fuck me, I'm sweating buckets. Excitement, that's all. That's all. We're all friends here, aren't we?
Relax.
I am relaxed. We're all in this together, aren't we? Oh, fuck, I'm gasping. Wow, champagne!
That's not for you.
We've got lager.
Great. Lager's great.
Naz!
Well, no one to think. After all, it is a party, ain't it?
Is she there?
Oh, no.
Party pieces in there.
Where are we doing it?
In there.
There's a bed to tie him on.
Oh, fuck me, I'm shaking. Exciting, that's all. No, every day while it's fucking fancy, you know, fucking life comes through, is it?
To wild fucking fantasies.
Wild fucking fantasies.
I need a hand in here.
Lola, this is the party guest.
Hello, party guest.
Wow. Hi, Lola.
Just a few more minutes, Lola. Naz.
Is there somewhere I can get changed?
Out there.
Yes, great.
Sphinx. I want the Duchess out of here.
She won't fucking see anything, will she?
She'll fucking hear it.
Is she? We tell her which next door is telling you something.
Don't joke about it.
I know it's on the film.
Don't joke about it.
What? You say what?
Sphinx, if she's here, I'm calling it off.
Oh! Oh, Jesus Christ! Not on too bad to see the party's off. The party's on. There'll be much on. Get used to it, both of you.
Lola? She can take the Duchess back with her, can't she?
What?
Yeah, no, Lola's going home after this.
Yeah, Lola never stays.
Sphinx, you can pick the Duchess up after the party's finished.
Yeah.
No.
Why not?
The Duchess is in too bad of a state to be that far away from her.
Oh, come on, Sphinx.
Lola can't handle the Duchess when she panics. You know that, don't you? Don't you?
Naz, mate.
Oh, do shut up.
No, go on.
Well, Naz, she's good with the Duchess.
She is. She's bloody brilliant. Come on, Sphinx, you've seen it yourself.
And Naz and Lola, if they're both with the Duchess, then
what? The Duchess should be fine, Sphinx.
I don't know.
Come on, you can't seriously expect her to sit here while we're in there.
I told you, I don't want the Duchess too far away from me.
We can take her to Naz's flat.
What?
The Duchess, Naz and Lola can take her back to
Naz's flat. Yes, come on, Sphinx, that is perfect. It's not that far away, but it's still far away
far
enough.
Far away enough so we can still have the party.
Exactly, Sphinx. Sphinx!
Nearly finished. Just need the air straight and I'll fuck him off. Ah, there. Right.
No, no.
So what are we going to do now then, eh?
Excuse me. Is it my idea to bring the Duchess here?
Don't talk to me like that. Show me some fucking respect.
Let me go.
Let me go, Sphinx.
Good into you all today, eh? The way you all look at me, all of you. I'm trying to do this for all of us, for fuck's sake. I'm trying to hold it all together, hold us together. It ain't fucking easy.
I know, Sphinx, I know.
It ain't fucking fair.
I know, Sphinx, look. What if it's just Naz? In Naz's flat, she won't hear anything.
We've got to go ahead with the party, Sphinx.
This is the only way, Sphinx. Please.
Ta-da! Oh, Jesus.
Too much?
It's perfect.
Well, what's the point of doing that fucking cook day? When I see some fly ones, I go for another one I've got. It's sad. I might have a chance to do something like this again. This is my fucking moment. I deserve it. You know, I've tried the odd butterfly. Don't tell my girlfriend, though. They're all right handy, but it ain't real, is it? It's a real blood. Real skin. Real pain. Ah, fuck!
I'm so excited! I feel like a little kid again!
Look, we've got you on then, eh?
Look at you. Oh, yeah! Good one, good one. Right, can we go over what's going to happen again?
We know what's going to happen.
Do we? Go over it again.
It's Vietnam. Think jungle. Think helicopters. Think sweat. Think insects as big as me face, the big poisonous fucking snakes. Think being out there for fucking ages. We wake up one morning, it's a sort of napalm. Helicopters like a swarm of something. It's brilliant. We've killed lots of any fucking scum. We've got a necklace made of human ears, and we shove grenades up girls' cunts and watch them. BAM!
Get on with it!
So, I call the company together. And you two, us three, that's all that's left. Now, cameras, they've been fucking shot. Picked off by snipers one at a fucking time. And our best mate, he's had his guts blown out, and they're gonna shove them up with a frying pan on.
Hurry up.
All right then. So, I called the company together and say, men! That's you two. Men! It's a traitor somewhere alarmist. That's why so many of us brave soldiers are being killed. So he knows exactly where to find us, all our details, everything. Now, I know the truth is in you, men. I trust you with my life, men. If somebody's on our side, but he ain't.
That bastard, I help.
But don't worry, because I think I might have just found out who this spy is.
How?
I intercept some. What could it fucking matter what I found out? I've just found out.
Alright.
Listen carefully. The two-faced traitors lying to this is someone on the entertainment corps. People sent over here from Rob. Now one of those singer and dancing entertainment cunts is passing information on to the fucking enemy.
Who?
Elvis fucking Presley. But the kid Elvis, young, really young. You listen, man?
Yeah,
we've been this kid, back here, to base. He's wearing that white suit. It sparkles, his ears and that perfect fucking quiff, his skin's all smooth and his little baby eyes are all bleeding and
hurry up!
So we gotta find out who's been speaking to him, what he said, and anything else the pretty Memphis boy cunt's got to say. And we've got to use every means at our disposal to make him fucking speak. Did you bring the meat cleaver?
Yeah.
Because I'm gonna stick that meat cleaver at him and I'm gonna twist it and you don't record me face for, yeah?
Told you no.
Good. Because I ain't wearing nothing. Nothing's getting in the way of me seeing, feeling, or hearing. So you being careful with that fucking camera.
Fucking hell, I've done this before, you know.
And you're using gas masks, right?
Yeah.
Whatever you like, let me see.
They're like what you asked for.
Yeah. Perfect, perfect. I best go and check the kit.
There's no time for a fashion parade.
You'll see him when we get started.
Daylight's fading. We need the light to film.
There's no electric.
Well, then we better get started then, haven't we? I don't want to get started. I don't just sort of end totally kosher, do I? Be fair.
Yes.
Look, I ain't questioning your artistic abilities or anything, just that. Well, fuck me, it's my day, isn't it?
So long as it stays day, not night, if it'll be, yeah?
Look, I'm sorry for being late. Hands up, my fault, shoot me. Look, how about this, eh? We kill two birds with one stone, or one kid with one meat cleaver.
What's he fucking doing in there?
Jesus, Nash!
Nash!
Yeah?
Bring a party piece in here.
In here now?
Where else do you think I'm fucking being?
I'll start getting in the mood while you check the kid. How's that, eh? We waste no time. Both these sounds.
Well, I hope it's got batteries.
Yeah, brand new. And the kid's being dumb, mate. I tell you, I've been ready to fucking hurt him so much, he'd be begging me to cut his fucking head off.
Wait. Nash?
What's he fucking doing?
Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck.
How's that, eh?
You dream? You don't think it could ever happen for real? And then one day, it's real. What's happened?
He's been drinking.
Who gave him water?
Not me.
Someone fucking did.
Sakes, you see, this is why he wanted to check him. For fuck's sake, Spinks, he better be alright.
He will be.
My sister went to wee! Flash, boom, flash, boom, flash, boom,
Dad,
flash, boom.
Take him outside, get cleaned up.
Dad.
Dad.
Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad.
Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad. Dad.
safe, everyone is safe. Duchess, Nance, why don't you go and show Duchess the palace's treasure?
Oh, yes, show me.
There's lots of treasure on the palace grounds, Duchess.
You like jewelry, don't you, Duchess?
Yes. Are the diamonds?
Yeah, the biggest diamonds in the world. From Egypt.
Papa?
So, right, Duchess, you need me, just call.
Fellow's not going to come out properly, is it?
He'll come out. Well?
Yeah, he's good, he's clean, he's just a bit, you know, well. I want to see things, you know.
And I told you, you will.
I want to play it back afterwards and see.
Let's get some candles.
Let me see.
One sec.
Is this enough?
They're fine.
That's not how it's gonna look.
That's how it's gonna look.
Yes.
Yeah? Speak to me!
Oh, for fuck's sake, he looks off his face!
He'll be fine.
I want to make sure you can feel things, you know.
And I told you, he fucking will.
Hold him.
We're doing the main business in there.
And all that, I want to make sure he can feel things first.
He fucking will.
We don't mind if I fucking check, do you? Hold him. Ah, for fuck's sake, he's off his face!
It was over too quick.
I broke his bone, for fuck's sake!
Give us your knife.
Eh?
Your knife, quick!
No! Not his face! Not yet.
Jesus Christ!
I've got to smash on something perfect, else there's no fucking point. Fair.
Take your shoe off.
What one?
Doesn't matter which fucking one!
It wasn't much.
But he felt it. And that was just on the outside with a knife.
Imagine what the inside with a meat cleaver would do, eh?
Imagine that, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So we getting started then? Does he know the song?
He knows a few words.
Oh, he's supposed to know the whole fucking song.
Darren's supposed to have 5 more days to teach him.
Listen. Elvis, he's been through a trek through the jungle, and he's tired, and he's shitting himself.
No shit.
He's not shitting himself, but he's tired, and he's scared, and, well, he tries to remember the song, but only odd words remain. Elvis, he hasn't got any more. Alacrity. Okay.
Yeah.
I suppose it can work. We'll see what it can do. If it does work, we get straight into business, so let's get ready.
Sing.
Sing.
Me tender. Love true.
I'm gonna hurt you.
Love me.
Oh, I'm ready! Quick now!
Let's get started!
Come on, now. Speak the sounds! Quick! Hurry up! Bring him with some fucking rags!
Sing so fucking long! Shit!
Speak!
Just 1 second.
What the?
Well, I've got a bit of a problem.
A problem? Ah, fuck! Jesus! Fucking tell me, don't tell me. He's fucking dead, isn't he?
Sure of you.
For fuck's sake, and he didn't look right!
Listen, you can still have some fun.
Fun?
He's still warm.
Warm? Jesus, who the fuck do you think I am, Ace Binks? I don't want him just warm. I want him moving. I want him screaming. Ah, fuck! Listen to you, Ace Binks. I'll pay for the meal like a fucking kid. If you don't get me one, you don't get a fucking thing. You hear me? I want a kid. A living kid. Now.
Wants more champagne.
No speech.
Shut it. Well?
She's a bit old.
She's more weight.
There's no quiff.
She'll struggle more.
She doesn't know the song.
She'll scream like hell.
And with the shoe fit?
Like a dream. Don't you pull that down.
What's going on?
Down!
No!
Shut the fuck up!
Stop it! Stop! Stop! Speak, please! Please help!
Shut the fuck up!
Speak! Come on, there's no shortage of people like him! Me and Daddy, we'll wait like fuck over the next few weeks!
We ain't got the next few weeks!
Speak!
She's got to know!
You can't tell anyone! I shouldn't have told you!
Listen, you stupid fuck! If I don't tell her, you don't get your chance! You never get your wild fucking fantasy come true, but you're going.
Why? Where's he going?
That's not your problem.
Another country. His old company's getting out.
Why? Tell me now, or I'm gonna fuck off.
Tell her. I can't hold the kid and film it. Tell her.
The bombing's gonna start.
What bombing?
What do you mean, what bombing? Bombing big fucking bombs. That one blows all to shit.
When?
The way it is. Tomorrow, but it could be sooner.
Do you hear that? Sooner? Could be any fucking time!
Yeah, alright, and how the fuck does he know?
His girlfriend's got connections!
Ah, for fuck's sake, Sphinx!
Tell her! Fucking tell her!
That's it. Well, there'll be 3 days of non-stop bombing. Firebombs, napalm, technology we haven't heard of before. After 3 days, the soldiers will move in.
What soldiers?
Do you want the fucking names?
Look, they'd be here to help you.
Help?
Look out the window, for fuck's sake. It's a shithole. Riots, no law. We need the fucking bombs and soldiers to bring back some order. And I'm all fucking for it.
Yeah, considering you ain't gonna fucking be here, right?
I'm not involved in this shit.
But you don't mind having your fun in this shit before you fuck off.
I'm paying for my fucking seat.
Yeah, and that's gonna do us the world of good when we're all blamed for
shit. It will! It will! Paying me contacts. Where to go, where to be safe. Listen, I'm trying to save us all here. And this is why we got to go along with this. Shut up. Have you forgotten, eh? What you were like when I first met you? You shit yourself if someone slammed the door too hard.
She was ill.
Shut it.
She'd been in the hospital.
Yeah, the hospital she went out of.
She was being attacked.
You there too, you stupid fuck! Lying in bed helpless! The big Giselle come back for you and she fucked off to safety.
I was in a different ward.
No.
Sphinx, don't!
You're in the same ward, hear me? You're in the same very next fucking bed. And your mum, she was in the bed next to that.
No.
Yeah. And here, that cowardly cunt. She forgotten all about you, didn't you?
Yeah.
Didn't you?
Yes!
Who came back after all that, eh? Who came back to save this fucking outfit and the Duchess? Me! The hospital was a fucking slaughterhouse. I was slipping in blood. 2 times you had to go in there, 2 fucking times! And who looked after you all after that, eh? Who gave you medical supplies and stuff, fed you, clothed you, told you how to survive in this fucking shithole, you fucking niggas, big cunt!
You, Sphinx.
Listen, if you don't have this party, we'll be stuck here. We'll be bombed. If you survive the bombs, which is not very likely, there'll be the soldiers. Do you know what the soldiers could do to the Duchess? Jesus Christ, what about Lola? Do you have any idea what kind of fun you could have with someone like her? You want to leave Lola to the soldiers, do you?
No.
Then go out and stick the fucking gas mask on. Clothes off.
Please, no.
Stuart!
Take the suit off the party, please. Do it!
Put it on.
Please.
Do it! Let's get started.
Help! Help! Don't make him!
That's it!
Help! No!
I'm gonna hurt you! I'm gonna hurt you!
Stop it!
Shut up!
Shut
up!
Show everyone out.
I want champagne.
There's the garden downstairs, don't you, being in the fireworks?
So that's what all the noise was. Oh, I adore fireworks.
Roses and fireworks, Duchess.
Naz, there you are, roses and fireworks.
Sphinx, can you take Naz down? Oh, we'll be coming too.
Well, I will see you down there then.
Sphinx, wait by the car.
What about me camera?
We'll get your fucking camera.
Come on, Duchess.
Bye.
Papa's leading the way. Al? Leg?
Al, leg!
Come on, Al. Space explorers! That's what you said? Before we did any of this, you said we're space explorers, right, sis?
Right.
And we're looking for a new planet to see if it's fit for human life, am I right, sis?
Yeah.
But there isn't anything, is there, sis?
No.
And we're looking for a more friendlier planet. And I know there's billions and trillions of planets, and well, one of them will be safe to live on. One of them will be safe. The petrol, come on. Ah, oh, El. The bombs. Shit. They've started them. They're everywhere! They're all down! They're coming down now, just like what the party gets said! Come on, put the gun away, we have to get out of the open. Come on, Al. Al, we can make it now, come on, we have to loop them. Al, come on. Get out of here, come on, Al. I love you so much that I can grab you and grab you. Remember? I love you so much that
Say it out.